Welcome student, today's lectures on cell injury, free radical, pathological calcifications. First I will discuss about cell injury, definition of cell injury. It may be defined as any adverse influence which derails the cell's ability to maintain a steady normal or adaptive homeostasis. I repeat, it may be defined as any adverse influence which derails the cell's ability to maintain a steady normal or adaptive homeostasis. Causes of cell injury: hypoxia, physical agents, chemical agents, infectious agents, immunological reactions, genetic rearrangements, nutritional imbalances. Now the cellular response to injury. Acute cell injury, irreversible two types, necrosis and apoptosis, subcellular alteration in sublethal and cell chronic cell injury, cellular adaptations, atrophy, hypertrophy, hyperplasia, metaplasia, intracellular accumulation, pathological calcification, cell aging. Now we'll discuss reversible cell injury and irreversible cell injury shortly by a diagrammatic representation. That is, this look at the picture. Reversible cell injury and irreversible injury, cell death due to ischemia, that is lack of oxygen supply to the cell. Oxygen is required for ATP production in the mitochondria. Due to lack of oxygen, decreased oxidative phosphorylation, decreased ATP. This decreased ATP causes different effects on cell. First, you know the cell membrane maintain the sodium potassium pump system. There is a balance between sodium potassium inside and outside of the cell. Due to lack of oxygen, ATP causes the efflux of the calcium from inside to outside of the cell, and sodium with water enter into cell with increased influx of the calcium. This sodium and water accumulation in the cell causes the cellular swelling, loss of microbial blasts, endoplasmic reticulum swellings, myelin fibers formations. Due to lack of oxygen, aerobic process for production of ATP is decreased, then anaerobic process is started, that is increased glycolysis, causes the decreased glycogen store, causes decreased pH, and that is increased hydrogen concentration, causes a complement of the nuclear chromatin. Other effects are detachment of ribosomes. We know that ribosomes produce protein. Detachment of ribosomes decrease protein synthesis and lipid depositions. Clamping of nuclear chromatin decreased pH causes the intracellular release of activation of lysosomal enzymes. If this stimulus, injurious stimulus, is persist long time, then irreversible cell injury occurs, that is cell death of the cell by membrane injury or intracellular release of an activation of lysosomal enzymes. Membrane injury causes the loss of phospholipids, cytoskeletal alteration, free radical, lipid pyrolysis, and others. Causes leakage of the enzyme, that is LDH, creatine kinase, increased calcium influx, calcium depositions. Our intracellular release and activation of lysosome causes the basophilia, decreased basophilia, nuclear change, protein digestion, that causes a cell death of the due to ischemic condition. Now free radicals. Free radicals are chemical species that have a single unbonded electron in an outer orbit. Important free radicals are oxygen derived free radicals, reactive synthesis, superoxide, hydrogen peroxide, nitric oxide. It can access free radical and can also produce reactive peroxy, nitric anion, carbon tetrachloride. These are the pictures shows the formation of free radicals by ultraviolet rays, air pollution, inflammation, or the smoking, ionizing radiation causes the DNA damage. Production site of free radicals in cells. This may be produced in plasma membrane, lysosome, mitochondria, cytosol of the cell by oxidative enzymes. Initiative factors are endogenous reactions, oxidative reaction, oxidative reaction, radiant energy, ultraviolet ray, excess metabolic process, tax chemicals. Effects: free radicals play a role in microbial killing by phagocytic cells, inflammatory enzymes, chemical injury to cells, radiation injury, cellular aging, destruction of tumor cells by macrophage. Mechanism of action: lipid peroxidation of membrane, damage to DNA, oxidative modification of protein. Inactivation of free radicals: it may occur oxidant, antioxidant, that is vitamin E, serum albumin, transmembrane, cytoplasmic, cysteine, glutathione. These are the antioxidant inactivation by inactivation of free radicals and enzymes, superoxide dismutase, catalyst glutathione peroxidase. Inactivation of free radicals. How antioxidant reduce the free radicals? Antioxidant donate the electron covering the unfree radicals. Attached to the unfree radicals causes prevention of free radical formation. Now, pathological classifications. Definitions: it is defined as abnormal deposition of calcium salt together with small amount of iron, magnesium, and other mineral salts. Abnormal deposition of calcium salt together with a smaller amount of iron, magnesium, and other mineral salts. Pathogenesis: the final common pathway is formation of crystalline calcium phosphate mineral in the form of apatite, similar to hydroxyapatite of bone. Two major phases: initiation and propagations. Matrix vesicles are extracellular membrane bound vesicles that part up from the cell. Calcium phosphate accumulation occurs in these matrix vesicles, then propagation, further growth of hydroxyapatite. Types: dystrophic calcification and metastatic calcification. Dystrophic calcification occurs in dead or dying tissues. Called dystrophic calcification, it occurs is the normal serum level. Common sites of the area of progressive calcific necrotic: leukophilic necrosis, foci enzymatic fat necrosis, advanced atherosclerosis, aging or damaged heart valve, tuberculosis, lymph nodes, infarcts, dead pancreas, hydatid cyst, thrombi, cyst like dermatosis, even fibroids. Metastatic calcification occurs in vital tissues. Calcium salt deposition in vital tissue known as metastatic calcification. It occurs due to some derangement calcium metabolism leading to hypercalcium. Causes: hyperparathyroidism, vitamin D intoxication, systemic sarcoidosis, hyperthyroidism, Meal calculus syndrome, multiple myeloma, renal failure, idiopathic hypercalcium of infancy, metastatic cancer. Are sites of metastatic calcification: interstitial tissues of blood vessels, kidney, lungs, gastric mucosa. Pathomembrane facilitated calcifications. The calcium ion binds the phospholipids present in membranes. A microcrystal develops after it has been in the phosphate active channels. Histologically, with hematogenous calcium salts have a vesoblic amorphous granules, sandwich clump appearances. They can be intercellular, extracellular, both in locations. The progressive acquisition of outer layer may create laminated configurations called the stromal bodies because of their resemblance to grains of sand, for example, papillary carcinoma of thyroids.